My name is Mapo Yisise. I work for the Voice newspaper. I wanted to know what truly makes you to abandon the state house and live in your house.
Thank you, Mapoji. You said abandon the state house. I've never lived in the state house. This is my residence. And I prefer to live in my residence until when everything is ready for me to move to the state house. I have to be given the clearance that it is ready for me to move. I didn't abandon it. I've never lived there.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, Mr. President. My name is Mohammed Lamin Ba. I'm from Dakar. I'm the correspondent of the Deutsche Welle, the German international radio based in Dakar. My question is, you expressed your will for ECOWAS troops to stay in the Gambia until 6 months at least, so you can set up your security in the whole country. ECOWAS troops is going to progressively leave the Gambia. What is your position about that decision? Thank you.
There is no time set for ECOWAS stay in the Gambia. They are here to help the process. And I think anytime we don't need them to continue in this country, we will work that out so that their services will finish in this country.
Good morning. My name is Ajit Rami. I work for West Coast Radio in the Gambia. Your Excellency, we heard from other news outlets that you've been invited for the AU summit in Addis Ababa, and we understand the invitation is extended to you. Will you be attending for the first time with other head of states? Thank you.
Because of very important things nationally, and I was not here for 2 weeks, I will not be able to travel, but the Vice President will represent me.
Good morning. My name is Ibrahim Khalilandia. I'm from a newspaper called La Soleil in Dakar. So we want to know if Gambia will still stay a Republic of Islamic.
Come back again.
Will Gambia stay a Islamic Republic?
Gambia will be the Republic of the Gambia, not Islamic Republic. It will be the Republic of the Gambia.
Good morning, Your Excellency. My name is Mamoru Diallo. I work at the Gambia Radio and Television Services. I just wanted to ask, when are you going to announce your full cabinet? As you know, there have been some kind of vacuum since the other government left, and since then people have been anticipating the announcement of the full government to start work.
This is a very important question. If you want the board to start rolling, we have to get our cabinet in place. That is by Monday, Tuesday, we'll announce our cabinet. And there are a few names that I have already contacted and they have been informed. So be our future cabinet, and by Tuesday or Monday or Tuesday, it will be officially announced.
Mr. President, first of all, congratulations. My name is Sheriff Boyang Jr., a Gambian journalist. My question, generally the concern is that you're going to inherit a government with no money, absolutely no money. Are you concerned that in the shortest time you will even struggle to pay salaries of government employees because of the bad state or the perceived bad state of the Gambian economy? Thank you.
Well, that is the general feeling of everybody. But we will get this information as at Monday or Tuesday to know what is the state of our economy. Then from there, then we can comment on it. But as of now, we have to wait for that.
Good morning, Mr. President. Barkaba from TFM. Ci wolof la le lacc sama question. Est-ce que deugante nga président Jammé depuis bu mu génné dëkk bi ak lan moy accord bu wa CDAO uy ñu wax né CDAO signé nañ ko ak mom lan mo ci am ak lan mo ci amul
bu mu fi joggé ak tay dégo wuñ way lëk signé ak luñ signé wut ñu mel dañ bëggoon pour ñu am peaceful ñu resolve problème bi peacefully loolu lañ bëggoon lolu amna dañ bëggone mu gëna dëkk bi bëggu mënu ñu garantie sécurité am ci dëkk bi lolu amna yenen waxtaan yi dina continuer resolution mo amone rek way agreement amut so lolu waxtaan yi dina continuer
Assalamu alaikum Abdou Cissé dakaractu.com man aussi xamna damay top ci sama tanku mak ci olof lañ bëgg parce que suñu lecteur dañuy bëgg di gis olof lima lay laacc ben bi mu ngi jëm ci nomination bi nga def Fatoumata Tamba Diang ñu bari dañ né da nga ko falté peut-être defo gëstu bi war nénañ mom dafa dépasser âge bi ñu laacc pour nek vice président ñu lay laacc sa xalaat ci lool benen bi dañu né sa ki nga fi nga fi wut mu Yaya Jamé ñu bari dañu wax ni dafa yobale ci caisse nguur gi alal ju bari amna sax ñu wax 11 millions de dollars ñu bëgg xam yow lan nga mëna tontu ci loolu ñu ngi lay jël ja jëfël
vice president buma nommé am nañ gom gom né ci loi lañ ko wër ñu nga xamné tam joxé nañ ci seen yeneen xalaat fokk nga gëné ay dalil yu wër nekku né da ngay tok rek nga war té xamna né dinañ woné ay kayit yi woné ay jam lolu dina xew pour nit ñi xam sa benen question bi lolu mënuñ sé wax fokk ñu waxtaan ak ñinga xamné ñu amé bunti yoyu bunti xaaliss bi su ñu joxé kayit yu leer ci lañu mëna wax ci lolu
Mr. President, my name is Alhaji Mane. I work with the Standard newspaper. So my question is, it could be recalled that you established a think tank to identify qualified Gambians to fill vacancies in your administration. Who are these thinkers, sir? Thank you.
I didn't get any report on that as of now. But for sure, by Monday, I'll be in office, or Tuesday. If I get the report, that's the time you can give your names. But as of now, I didn't get any report on that.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. President. My name's Mamadou Idrissa Ndiaye, a journalist and a blogger with the Mansa Banco News Online. Okay, my question is, what are your plans for the children of the Gambia? And is your government ready to establish Ministry for Children Affairs that will provide quality education, protection of children against all forms of abuse, and exploitation. And in addition to that also, a human rights commission draft is already in place. So is your government going to implement that?
I think there is a minister responsible for youths. And when we said youths, I think that will cover all that. We won this election the platform of democracy, and we want to make sure we establish democracy in this country, the rule of law, that will be the order of the day. I think that will help us to solve all those human rights problems that people have been talking about.
Good morning, Mr. President. This is Carly with the Associated Press. Can you tell us what you foresee as Gambia's greatest challenges moving forward and how your administration plans to address those?
The greatest challenge is there was a government here for 22 years. 22 years is a long time. And we are able to change the government after 22 years. So obviously, there will be a lot of challenges to look at all the system and make a complete overhaul. I think that is a big challenge to my new government.
Thank you very much. I am Mustafa Dabo. My question is, with regards to the former government, some of the abuses that have happened during the past regime, each time your government speaks on this, all the coalition stakeholders emphasizes reconciliation, truth. But there are people who some of people who have been in detention for 3 years, 6 months, there are those who have not still seen their relatives, even after an executive order for them to be released. which probably gives an assumption that probably they have died. Will there be any form of compensation from your government for victims of the previous regime? Thank you.
I think we are all speaking on one voice. There will be Truth and Reconciliation Commission. And that commission will be mandated to look at every avenue and make a report. Based on that report, there will be recommendations, and we will respect those recommendations.
Thank you very much. My name is Binam S. Diop from Taranga FM. My question is, we have seen so many irregularities in the constitution. What is your government doing towards that?
As I said, there will be an overhaul, and there will be reforms in the system of government so that we can put everything in place and we respect the principles of democracy. This is what we want to do immediately.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, Monsieur le Président. Maay tuddu Boubacar Tamba, Radio Sud FM Sénégal. Man duma dan sawara ñew Gambie ndax NIA. Dembu romb na fa fekk buntu teju, may laaj ndax NIA dina wëy wala bok di ngeen ko sétat. Ma jéxale rek laaj la ndax di nga sol maayo Sénégal tay ci jongante ak Cameroun.
NIA banga ci nguur gi la. Mu nga xamné mo amé affaire intelligence. Si dekk bi fi banxas bobu dina nek banxas bo xamne dafay continuer di liguey waxe na liguey bi dafay outé té ñu ngi am yaakar né dinañ wéci tour bi pour ñu am benen tour té sen liguey tam dafay outé bi yon dafa am intelligence ñu wara liguey yoyu dinañ ko sétat dinañ def reforms yoyu pour sen liguey gëna and ak loi bi moy Sénégal goman dina ko sol way dina support Sénégal.
Good morning, Your Excellency, and congratulations. Like my colleagues have said, my name is Sankola Janko from Unique FM Radio. The truth be spoken, the Gambia has never been polarized as it is today, and for you to have a smooth running affairs of this country, people must come together as one people. My question is, which mechanisms are you putting in place to see to it that even the supporters of APRC and GDC will feel the sense of belonging, that they all belong, and this government is not here for only one party, but instead the entire Gambian population?
I think we have already answered your question. We won this election on democratic principle, and we want to make sure we continue in that line. And there will be a complete reform of all democratic processes in this country. And I think if we get that, the field will be labeled for everybody. And in truth and reconciliation, if people reconcile, that will unite everybody. And we want to work on that line. Thank you.
Good morning, Mr. President. The ECOWAS Community Court of Justice in Abuja has in the past ruled against the Gambia government in the case of Musa Sidikan versus the Gambian state, as well as in the case of Chief Mane versus the state, and recommended that the Gambia government should compensate both of them. Would your government adhere to the decision of the ECOWAS Committee Court of Justice by compensating those individuals?
We will look at this crucially, and our expert will advise us on what we can do about that. But as of now, we have to wait until then.
Good morning. My name is Adama Barrow. I work with Foreign Newspaper. I want to know, because time ago, just a few weeks back, some of our people went to Senegal and be there as refugees. And to my knowledge, in Karong, more than 3,000 people were in Karong. And some of the people in Karang, the residents, like, they willingly and wholeheartedly gave their compounds to the Gambians for them to stay freely. They cook for them. I want to know whether the Gambian government will compensate them, the Senegalese people.
I think it was a goodwill gesture. I don't think anybody is asking for compensation. What the Gambia government did is to try and get the repatriated back to the Gambia. I think that was done. I think about 42,000 people have been repatriated back to the Gambia. I think that's what we have done as at now. I think nobody is asking for compensation.
My name is Fabara Fofana, serving as a stringer for CNN Banjo. There has been talks of the Gambianization of the judiciary for a long time under the former regime. And then we've seen a lot of our key judicial positions manned by foreigners, Nigerians in particular. What measures have you got in place to make sure that dream is realized, that we have Gambians serving in top judicial functions, given the kind of situation recently experienced here in the wake of this election?
You will see a lot of Gambians in the judiciary sector, but if there is need for any technical assistance outside, I think we will welcome that also.
Good morning, Mr. President. A big part of your campaign was rooting out corruption in the system. How exactly do you intend to do this? And you talked about truth and reconciliation. What will be their mandate, the Truth and Reconciliation Committee? What exactly will be their mandate? Thank you.
When we said truth and reconciliation, I think before you make any decision, you get to the truth first and you reconcile. Their mandate is very wide. They will examine every case and make a report. Then based on that, government will act. And at the same time, when you have democratic principles in place, I think that will always help to control corruption, good governance. This is exactly what my government wants to do.
Assalamu alaikum, President Barrow. Malama Gendong, du Cordier National, Le Soleil Dakar. Ben question bi moy President Diabet dafa jël une décision retirer Gambie de la CPI, moy International Penal Court. Est-ce que yow décision bobu dang koy deugal wala dang koy remettre en cause?
Wat.
Mani président Jame dafa jëlone ben décision moy retirer Gambie de la ICC way. Légui est-ce que yow décision bobu dang koy deugal wala dang koy remettre en cause tayji? Ben question bi moy pont bi nga xamne mo wara dox ci Sénégal ak Gambie. Pont bobu wax deug sen dafa soxal lol wa Sénégal. Est-ce que yow di jappato? Merci.
ICC gomane Gambia dina joge ci ICC su nekké ñu ngi wax démocratie ak rule of law mu ngi melni ICC tam lool la mo advocate kon gomane Gambia warna ragal pour wara bokka fofu duñ fa joggé affaire pont bi loolu yag nañ ko waxtaan sun nguur gi suñ togué dinañ ko gestu dinañ am ñinga xamné ñu macha xam xam lañ ci walu bobu dinañ ko sét lu ci war ñu def ko.
Mr. President, I
good morning, Mr. President. My name is Sarah Kamara from Star FM Radio. I want to know how you intend to work with the media in the Gambia, because since in the previous regime, especially the private media, they are marginalized. So how best are you going to work with them?
I think you will be media friendly. I think since the 1st of December, you have seen the changes. I think the media are more comfortable now than before. And we will look at the media bill so that there will be reform in that area to make sure people are informed. We believe that if people are informed, they are enlightened. And I think we need that in our society.
Hello, Mr. President. My name is Abdullahi C. I work with the Gambia Radio and Television Services. My question is, you've been advocating for democracy and, of course, rooting out corruption throughout the campaign, and I'm sure you want to pursue this. I want to know if you are willing to emphasize or advise your ministers to declare their assets. We understand that it's not a legal requirement, but would you require your ministers, for the sake of transparency, declare their assets before the Azum office? Thank you.
I think that will happen. All ministers will declare their assets. Because even myself, before I contest election, I declare my assets for in the interest of transparency and accountability. That will happen. So.
Okay, assalamu alaikum Mr. President. Man Omar Tougar la tudama yo joge Safa Radio. Li ma don laccé mom modi ne. Bi nga falé ki nga amné mom modi massa nekinde pour nga def ko sa military aid advance fu nekani tioli bari na ci dekkabi. Ndax dang ko remplacer def ko ci DS? Nda do ko def ci DS fu nekani lolou la nit ñi di laccé. La nga se mëna léral.
Fonna soxla nañ ku am ham ham si walu sordar mu wara advice president bi ak dekkabi si walu bob. So dafa am place bo xamni dañ ko soxla lota ñu create place bobu pour muy advice president bi di advice tam soldat lolu duñ ci wéti sun halat.
As your press news agency, under the Jammeh regime, we know that corruption has become a sporting activity in the Gambia, and the justification that many people used to, you know, put forward is the salary are very poor. So what are the plans that your government is going to implement in order to make sure that the salaries is based on the real cost of living?
My government is going to look at every avenue, and there will be a complete overhaul of the whole system. In that overhaul, we will have recommendations. I think we will look at all those things and take the best decision as soon as possible.
Graphium, Lavin Cham, the Standard. Mr. President, there have been many decisions that were what I would call decrees or proclamations by presidents which stopped businesses and threw out hundreds of people out of employment and closed media houses. Moves that were not backed by law. For example, the Daily News newspaper, up to this time, is not published, that has not been closed by any form of procedure. Operators in businesses such as casinos, lotteries, have all had their businesses stopped. Now, do they have to wait for another presidential directive to resume, or would they get back to work immediately? And also, you said you'll be watching the African Nations Cup quarterfinals today, supporting Senegal. Are you not touched as a president that your country has never reached that stage, and what would be your efforts to see that the next African Nations Cup, the Gambia, appears there? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lamin Cham. I think the issue of executive directives, that will be over in this country. There will be no directive. What we're going to do is we follow the rule of law. Basically, in that with democratic principle, you have to follow the rule of law. When you say executive directives, it is always, it makes the job very difficult for everybody. We don't want to use our powers, we want to follow the law. Gambia, I think it's unfortunate. Gambia was at a level higher than a lot of countries. Now we have gone below them. We look at that crucially. As a sport journalist, I think you will be in that committee to advise what best we can do to improve our national squad. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Binta Jiang. I work for RFI. Mr. President, since many years, we've seen that many rebels called MFDC in some parts of the country. How are you going to handle with this issue?
This is a customer's issue that have been on for years. I think Gambia and Senegal, we are all the same. If there is a problem in the Gambia, the same problem will reflect in Senegal. See, during the course of this short period, how many people have fled to Senegal? So we'll always cooperate with the Senegalese government to help resolve the problem in Casamas.
Jennifer Imani, AFP. I think everybody has been struck by the professionalism we've seen from the foreign forces here, especially the Senegalese troops that we've met. They benefit from a close cooperation with France and with the US in terms of training. As you reform your own army, are you thinking of using training from other African nations or from the West in terms of revamping the army and the way that it works in the Gambia?
You are talking about reforms? Yes, when we say reform, is every area that we want to reform. overhaul of every sector. And the army, if you need technical aid, we will contact countries that are willing to help us to set the army.
Good morning. My name is Kadi Cham from Paradise FM. Mr. President, we have seen the youth since day one. They have been behind you since day one. And what measures are you taking in place in order for them to have a strong voice at the parliament? And are you trying to create job opportunities for them? Because they were all chanting that no more back way.
My government is committed to that, and we want to bring a system in place that will create jobs. In this creation of jobs, we want businesses to open in this country. And if that happens, I think that will create jobs. We are looking at the fishing industry also. In that industry, it has not been exploited by Gambia. We want to work on that so that we can create jobs. In that line, we want businessmen to go into production, light industries. This last industry is manufacturing. When you are into buying and selling, you become a liability. We want people to go into production, whereby you can compete in the market, you create jobs. And I think the youths will be very important because they are the labor force. So we are putting it into account to help the youths, so we employ it. Of course, yes. They were our foot soldiers. I think the youth make a big difference in these elections. They will have a voice.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Lamin Jahade. Sir, the Gambia is currently working on a four-day work week because the country has been declared an Islamic Republic. Friday has been off from our five-day work week. Are we expecting the Gambia returning back to a four-day work week, or you are going to maintain this? Are you expecting to go back to the 5 days, or you are going to maintain the 4 days work week? And also, you've been emphasizing the issue of constitutional reform in the legal service. Does this mean complete overhaul of the constitution, coming with a new one or an amendment of the existing one? Thank you.
Not coming up with a new one, but continue the existing one and amendments. The 5 days, I think we are thinking in that line. You start work from 8 to 6 is a long period. Sometimes before you get home, it's late. I think we will come back to the 5 days. That will be more preferable, I think, for many Gambians.
Thank you very much. Mr. President, my name is Ibu Wage. I am a Reuters reporter in the Gambia. Mr. President, we have all seen how Gambia has been put on the spotlight by the international media and the coverage it has given to this country. In that same vein, we have also seen how ECOWAS and the UN defended the choice of Gambians. Our neighbors, Senegal, are at the forefront, and their support has been tremendous. Going forward, what close relationship with Senegal do you have in mind?
Senegal, they are our neighbors. We are so close to Senegal. It looks like we are the same country. We speak the same language. We eat the same type of food. If you are in Senegal, it looks like you are in the Gambia. I think there will be close relationship between the Gambia and Senegal. We will always collaborate so that to avoid misunderstanding between Gambia and Senegal. We will improve the relationship.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm back again, Mohamed Lamine Ba. I want to know what is the importance, how important is tourism in the economy of the Gambia?
Tourism is very important. I think it's 20% of the GDP. So it is very, very important. And we want to improve the tourism sector so that it can be year-round. Because it's just 9 months, people are redundant. We want it to be year-round. So we will try to improve that. We'll work very hard to improve that to be 1 year-round.
I just want to once again ask a question concerning our relationship with Senegal. I've been listening to the Senegalese media, particularly TFM, and some of the experts have been talking about having some kind of a very, very special relationship with Senegal, given the fact that Senegal intervened in the Gambia. In return, this would be more or less Gambia owed them some kind of a debt, like some have been calling for a union. Are you thinking of that, or what would be the basis of the relationship between the Gambia and Senegal?
If you say Senegal, that will be misleading. It is ECOWAS. So it's not based on that. It's based on Gambia and Senegal are very close. Senegal have surrounded Gambia from all ends. Senegal have interest in the Gambia, whilst we have the same interest in Senegal. If you cross, you have to cross from Senegal to the other end, you have to pass through the Gambia. So basically, we are the same. The relationship should be like that. That's why we emphasize that we should be very close to Senegal.
Mr. President, during the Madeleine Baji, Radio Gambia. Thank you. Mr. President, so many people during the previous regime have been dismissed, if I can use the word, illegally. Are we looking at a point where they can come back to offer their services to the country? Will your government welcome that? And the Gambia, more or less, has been alienated from the rest of the world. What plans do you have in place to open up to the international community? Thank you.
I think every Gambian have the right to work the Gambia government. And people who have been dismissed, we will look at everything and see why they were dismissed. But every Gambian have the right to work with the Gambia government. Your second question is, what is your second question? We will open up to the global world. Gambia cannot be isolated. We open up to the global world and we respect all protocol.
So, Mr. President, I want to ask you a question in Polar. Hechanki Nungatrodande, Dental Gal Hewi, Yimbe Gambina, and getting Jet Bamanu Fee, and Rujida de Lumahulain, after a Kowat Warma, Nemjet Birmani, Hulbinanima, Parapor, a challenge Munjugidadi, Defiwidi.
No impeja or come ni Hulbinani come. Sabu ko he hare men gonno hare democracy nden hare ko nden timmi on nyande kon yimbe be di porti yaltude be kollira weltare mabbe kon de weltare be kolliri dun non men kebani hakkil didi ko non be potno yaltude sabu ko hare wonno ko hare politique si wadi ha goto ganyima tan kon non yarata.
Yes, thank you very much. Biram S. Job again, Tarang FM. My question is regarding the election bill. What is your government going to do on that? Because most of the political parties were complaining about the election reform.
Say that again.
The election bill. That was the registration of new political parties, presidential candidate, and the list goes on. What is your government stand towards that?
Election date.
The election bill.
Okay, election bill, okay. I think we have been on the other side of the coin all the time. We've always been complaining about laws that don't create environment for everybody to operate. We will make it very easy for every Gambian to register a political party, and there will be a complete reform on that, so that the field will be very level for everybody to operate. Freely and fairly. Definitely that will be part of what we are going to do.
Please, Lamin Jahada is my name once again. As we await the naming of the ministries on Monday or Tuesday, are we expecting the same number of ministries as in the previous government, or some ministries will be merged and you come with new ones?
We are expecting the same number to continue.
Sir, does your government have any plan whatsoever to do an audit of the civil service? And if so, how soon do you think this will come into effect?
Well, as I said, there will be a commission that will look at every avenue. If there is need for that audit, it will be audited. But it will be based on recommendation. We have this think tank, we will bring knowledgeable people together to make this commission and give us recommendation. Based on that, we will act.
Alajumane, once again, sir. You said every Gambian have the right to work for your government. And of course, that includes also the members of the seven different parties that made up of the coalition team. Are you not concerned or worried about appointing? Are you not concerned about are you not concerned about some of these coalition members? Because since you indicated that they all have the right to work for the Gambia government, we understand that there might something might come up that I would like to call conflict of interest. How do you intend to address this? Different parties, different agendas.
Different agendas, but we compromise to come together. And up to today, I think we are the same family, and that family will reflect the government.
Thank you. Mafuji Sise again. Okay.
And would your government consider setting up media commission since the Gambia journalists are the less paid in the world?
Well, I think we cannot set that for journalists. But we will promise you that there will be a reform and there will be a media bill that will accommodate all journalists. We will be media friendly. You will operate in a free environment. We promise you that.
Yeah, Sheriff here again. So your mandate is three-term transition period. Our constitution is five-year term. And I guess there is something so beautiful about presidency that propel our leaders to hang on to power even beyond their constitutional mandate. Once again, I know you made this, you signed this document to say you will leave after 3 years. Can we have you on record right here to say, despite what, whether you complete your job or not, or whatever project you have, at the end of the 3 year term, you will leave and we will go to the polls again?
It's a coalition. The agreement is 3 years. We have a mandate to do within that 3 years. It depends on the coalition now, whether the job is completed in 3 years or not. But as of now, it is 3 years. It depends on the coalition, not me.
Would you like to hang on to power?
I think I have made answer your question. It's the coalition, not me.
Mr. President, once again, Sarah Kamara from Star FM Radio. There's a picture of you circulating on the internet, on social media, of you giving out money. So many people are saying it is Photoshop, others are saying it's real. Is it true?
Well, I think it's true, but this is just $200. I don't think that is much.
All right, it's Abdullah here again. My question is regarding the Yeli Tenla Bamba Tenda Bridge. We understand it has been a bone of contention between the Gambia and Senegal. And Senegal, when it constructed in the soonest possible time, Gambia, too, I'm sure the government will be willing to construct it. We have conservationists saying that if it is constructed open-ended, it's going to block the entire River Gambia, which is the beauty of the country. People are saying that perhaps in the future there could be a port in Base, and you know, ships have to use the River Gambia. So my question is, are you considering constructing open-ended, or are you going to construct it in a suspension form? Thank you.
Well, I think I've answered the question. We have to look at it. I get a comprehensive report of what is there. Then that's the time our technician will advise us what to do and what not to do. But the government interest is very important here. We look at everything and make sure the government interest is looked at closely, definitely.
Okay, Your Excellency, for the third time, I would just like to ask, the last time when the former president was leaving, he signed some kind of a will where he asked you to dispose some of his assets. around in CRR, there is a Jahari Pachar, dispose some of the rice and some of the materials. Now, I just want to ask, what will happen to some of the assets of the former president, which most of you we know was acquired, I would say illegally. And he has also given you a task to dispose of some of these assets and give the rice to the women and do some other work. Are you going to do that or what?
Well, officially, I didn't get the letter. I just see it in the media. That now, I have to look at the document itself and see what best I can do about that. It was a goodwill gesture. I will look at it closely.
What, if you look at it, would you do as he said, that is, dispose some of the rice to the women and do some of the other instructions he asked you to do?
I will wait until if I get the document in my hand. This time I can comment on that.
Mr. President, Senegal, bimoy ñettal yoon mu fi ñew, for the Kaba 1, for the Kaba 2, legi operation Misega. Waye liñu nemeku moy ñun gisunu fi ay monument yo xamne da fay honorer mémoire suñu soldat yi nga xamne dañu ñakkon fi sen bakan. Est-ce que di nga def dara pour suñu démé fenn ñu gis ben makan bo xamne day woné né ay doomu Senegal ñak nañ sen bakan pour Gambia?
Lolo xamne la awma si xam xam bu baax waye wax nga ko ni dinañ ko note ñu set ko su nekké dafa jar mën nañ ko def waye goma ne Gambia sa amna monument bi amna yenen Gambian yu nga ni passé nañ fi ligéel nañ rew bi waye gisuma sen monument fi waye dinañ ko set.
Mr. President, Haji Drame from West Coast again. My question this time will go to our brothers and sisters who are in the diaspora. As we speak, there are Gambians who are still in Libya trying to take the rich journey to Europe. And recently we've seen some other Gambians in Angola treated somehow that is not welcome by the Gambian public. How soon do you intend to look at the welfare of Gambians who have been, you know, struggling with life outside this country?
See, we have representatives in those countries, our ambassadors, we will contact them and see what best the Gambia government can do for those Gambians who are stranded, either one way or the other.
Thank you so much, Mr. President. I am Sekou Jammeh for Radio France International. Could you tell us briefly what concrete actions you intend to take within your first 100 days in office?
First 100 days, we want to get cabinet in place, and we want to institute this think tank to make so they prepare a comprehensive report in every area that will help this government to move.
Mr. President, my name is Aruna Drame, Paradise FM. We first apologize that you didn't get the transition period that you were supposed to, but we want you to hit the ground running immediately. And I also want to apologize for the public media and the disservice that they have done. As part of the media, I'm embarrassed of ourselves. What will you do going forward with the public media? Because apparently they have not done their job well. Having said that, we seem to be the only country in this part of the world without a private TV station. Personally, I had written an application since 2009 and following it through. What will your government do not only to free up the media space, but to make it participatory that all views can be heard and continue to be heard without us fearing the NIA and five-star hotel on the Banjul Highway?
That's why we said there will be reforms. And there will be this media bill, we'll review it so that it can create the environment for the media to operate freely. And if that happens, I think everybody can operate. We can issue licenses to people who want to establish media houses in this country. We want people to get information. Well, through that information, we were able to win elections. During our campaign, we don't have access to GRTS. But because of the social media, these WhatsApps and all sort of, people were informed. That information influenced a lot of people to vote for the coalition. I think we benefited from that. And we want every Gambian or every person in this world to benefit from that. The media is here to educate people. If you educate them, you have empowered them to make their decision independently. I think we are thinking in that line, and we will be very, very media friendly. Because with the media, you have a lot to learn. With the media, it will help you to improve on where there is lapses. So this is something that we are thinking. And when you are talking about democracy, rule of law, you have to think about the media. The media must be free. Mr. Haruna, from today, I think the media is free in the Gambia.
Ousmane Lay Diop, Journal Enquête Dakar. Ousmane, CDS, Ousmane Badié, ak sa opposition, lo len denjal.
Wahalat.
CDS, Chief of Defense Staff, Ousmane Badié, ak sa opposition, lan nga len denjal.
Suma opposition?
Waaw, opposition bu bes bi ket dal manam.
Ah. Waaw, wax nga diga, opposition bu bes bi moy APRC. Ah. Ousmane Badié njiti armée bi la place liguey kay la bu nga xamné gambian la mo ngi nek fofu kon mo ngi melni mom liguey am lay continuer lolou la moy def opposition bu bes bi nak xamna né amna boré bu metti lolou so nekké ci nguur ñaari fukki at ak ñaar mu am opposition yu bolo ñetti wër ñu gëné la so waré taxaw bari waat ak ñom xamna dina metti ci yow loolu la am pour wax leen waye affaire yi démocratie la ñun ñepp ñoo bokk réew mi ñun ñoy ñepp ñoy ben affaire rek mën na leen ko wax ñun lu nga xamné duñ ko doon enjoy lu nga xamné sun right la duñ ko doon mën am ñoo dinañ ko am bi yow dinañ leen jox seen gëda dama mu sék ñu xamné réew mi dal gambian si ñoko mom décision bi gambian lay duñu ragal né suñ défé lolu dinañ daanu wala duñ daan bu so gisé nguur gi mu daan dafa am loi yu issue mu fune loi yoyu ñoko gëna dimbalé pour mu continuer bu ñëka so taxawé élection fo nga am 50% ak lu ci téggu nga mëna nekk président ñu gis né lolu baax su ñom ñu wañé ko né mu rek raw gaadu té si raw gaadu lolu lañ daanalé kon loy def rek defal lu baax rek mo gën so non lañu doxale duñu ragal ci affaire yi daan wala ñaka daan lolu ci gambian la dess
ah mr president bu bakkar tamba su def ñewatina ku wax nguuru yaay jambe ñaar fukkat ak ñaar dal di wax kanilay ak festivalam kanilay amna yu bari ñuy wax ni mu ngi fofu laxu ndax mën nañu xaar ci sa nguur ñu chambar li nga xamanteni mo nak kanilay lan la fa yaay jambe lak ak non nga koy defé
nga kanilay ñun duñ continuer lolu ci réew mi lu nga xamné lolu la doon def lolu lañu continuer di def
Mr President Ibu Wage Mr President for 22 years we journalists in the Gambia have not had this occasion this kind of occasion to have a press conference with the President of the Republic. This is your first press conference with the journalists. Can you promise that this is going to be the case? And can you say once every month you will do this?
I cannot set a period, but I know you will continue to enjoy this. With this, we can learn from each other. With this, people will be informed. And that information is fundamental. Is very important. So this will continue.
Sir, Abdullah from Al Arabi TV in London. For the first, I want to ask what kind of relation you look with the neighborhood, Senegal and Mauritania, precisely?
Senegal and Mauritania. They are our neighbors. You have a lot of Senegalese, a lot of Mauritanians in the Gambia. You have a lot of Gambians in Senegal and Mauritania. That neighborhood relationship will continue. And I think we will improve that relationship to an other level. So we have been together for years. I think that togetherness will continue.
Madeline Baji, Radio Gambia. Mr. President, parliamentary elections are around the corner. Are we looking at a situation where all the coalition parties will put in their individual candidates, or it's going to stay as we did in the presidential elections? And what does your government intend to do with the assets of the former president? And are we looking at a situation where Kanilai, the presidential residence, will be a museum if he doesn't come back to the country? Thank you.
Elections are coming. That is National Assembly elections. We are a coalition. We will continue as a coalition. We will continue as a family to challenge the new opposition, that is the APRC. So we will continue as a family. With the president's assets, there is nothing I can say as of now. Until we get back to office, then we will have people who will make recommendations, and we see how we go about it.
السلام عليكم سيد الرئيس مرحبا ممكن اطرح سؤالي باللغه العربيه صحافه الموريتانية en français alors je suis plus à l'aise en français et en arabe sinon je vais me débrouiller en wolof
wolof
d'accord demain une autre question benen pourquoi vous n'avez pas donné d'interview depuis votre élection à la presse arabe
why you didn't give an interview for Arabic TV like Al-Arabie TV?
Why didn't I give what?
We are 400 million de personnes et nous sommes des partenaires stratégiques de la Gambie, nous les Arabes. Ça c'est d'un. De deux, est-ce que vous allez est-ce que vous allez rejeter une partie de la du traité des médias entre les médiateurs de la CDAO et de la Mauritanie avec Adama, surtout le point qui concerne l'impunité. Est-ce qu'il y a quelqu'un qui... Pour l'impunité, est-ce que monsieur le président va juger Adama?
Bon. Yom limuy laaj modi lan mo tax bobu ba legui accordé au interview presse arabe bi té presse bu stratégique la bo xamné daf la jappalé mune ndax di nga juger yaaya jamé lolou moy question bi nga xamné mom mo mujj yeah mune jeex na tak
ñun ci sun ñu nga xamné ñew na interview ñu fi ñoo lañ waxal gisuma ben arab channel bu nga xamné ñew na la ci interview ñu né ko duñ la jox interview ba paré Al Jazeera fona Arab Channel ñew na fi defal nañ ko interview amna Mauritanian journalist bu fi ñewon interview nañ ko koku taw joxon nañ ko interview pour juger Yaya Jammeh nekuñ di wax lolu ñu dañu am commission bu nga xamné dina def recommendation ci recommendation yu lañu xam lan lañ wara def lan lañ wara def
Hello, Mr. President, once again, Ajemoso. My question is, I want to ask you whether you will appoint any member of the previous regime to any ministerial position. And the other question is, do you know the 50 members that the former president, Yahya Jammeh, left with?
The first question is,
will you appoint?
Yeah, I know. In cabinet. I said no. I think we have eight parties as a coalition. We have enough manpower to take up that challenge. There'll be nothing like that. And actually, I don't know how many people Yahya Jammeh left with. We will come to know it maybe later, but I don't know, actually. I don't know.
Abdou Cissé, Dakar Actu. Monsieur le Président, dafa am ñuy wax ni yow président par défaut nga té moy ya fi seuss motax nga falu benen bi dafa am lo diglé won lo waxon ni ding ko def té moy bo togué ñetti at da ngay joxé kenen ñew est-ce que lolu té yaangi ci ba légui
si sa première question bi ya fi seuss mo ngou mané amna ci ben réew because Gambia 1.8 million nit ñoo nek Gambia fi political party yu bolo dem na be juroom ñett parti kon ya fi ses mom bobu amut fofu ben affaire rek mën na la ko wax parti yu bolo ñu ne dañ dem election ci election bobu ñu tanam ma nek candidat non la ñewé pour nek candidat nekut na fofu ma fi ses bobu kay amut lolu lañ d'accord lolu lañ bind ci sun keyit ñetti at bi dafa am liggéey bi ñu wara sumba liggéey bobu dinañ har sun tanki tubé pour def ko ci ñetti at su mu ne nekk ci ñetti at baxna waaye dafa des ci coalition bi ñetti at bobu si liggéey bi jeexé ndax jeexut lan lañ wara def naka lañu continuer li affaire état la
Lamine Cham, Standard. Again, Mr. President, when you were elected, and the mic is working, and the manner your victory has been greeted, and this was of course amplified again at the Banjul Airport during your welcome, everybody cherishes the newfound freedom that the Gambia has. Everywhere we go as journalists, we have been told, "Oh, now you are free," and we will obviously be concerned about how much you will guarantee this freedom once again. And no, I'm not representing any business, but I want to push this question to you again, because I said so many people have been put out of jobs through presidential directives which arbitrarily closed their businesses without being backed by law. Do they have to wait for another presidential directive, or do they start their business right away? Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, I think I've answered this question. I'll come back to the same thing again. Gambia will not be run by presidential directives anymore. I'll be in office tomorrow. We will look at this closely, and I'll be advised to what we're supposed to do, what will be our next move. And the freedom, I think this freedom will continue. That's why we want to make a complete overhaul, a complete reform of the whole system, so that we will have the rule of law, we will have democratic principles. A democratic principle, I think that will have bring the environment for everybody to be free.